through the Jessica Sanchez story and the Mariposa Network, which today will take you through a journey through both. With Jessica, you're gonna see great strength in dealing with the adversities of overcoming a terrible, terrible tragedy. The family itself has endured so much, and they will be a testament to everything that's gone on. And when you see this and you realize that it's not just what the family has had to go through, it's what people all over the country are going through. What you're gonna see today is an incredible, incredible story of strength and hope and faith. And through this family, you'll begin to understand why it's so important to love every day, why it's so important to care for each other every day and not let one moment pass where that doesn't happen. You'll see why Tara put together the Mariposa Network. It was put in place to help other families with brain trauma, injuries, and situations where they also don't have insurance, they don't have the help, they don't even have the knowledge of where to look. I want everybody out there who sees this to understand that everybody needs a helping hand. If you can give just $1 towards the organization, $10, whatever, if you know somebody in need that needs help, please contact the Mariposa Network. We hope you enjoy the story today. Thank you very much.
She was a varsity cheerleader. She just made varsity cheer at La Cueva. She's with her friends here, there, everywhere. I mean, she's a social butterfly.
That night, it was summer, and of course, Jessica, she always wanted to be with Lily, so she was asking to spend the night that night at Lily's house. And I agreed. About 11 o'clock that night is when I got the phone call, and another one of her friends apparently was with them that night, and I don't know if she saw the accident, but she was coming down the street and she found them. At first, I just thought it was a car accident. I didn't think it was as severe as it was. But when she told me, I think she's still breathing, my whole body just went numb.
We didn't know all the details behind the accident. And then when we found out that it was a rollover, we knew the severity of the accident. It was very painful. We were just hoping that it was just no injuries, and we find out that Jessica was taken to a university hospital. We, at that point, when we were in the waiting room, we didn't know any details at all if she even survived the accident.
We waited in the waiting room at UNM for 7 hours before we got to see her. And it was the longest 7 hours of my life.
When we received word that she was accepted to go to Craig, it was the greatest moment, because we were told by the staff at UNM that we had to get her there. That was her best chance. And we were so elated to know that she was going to get the best medical care in the world. It was just a blur until we finally got up to Craig and we found out the severity and what they could do and what we were up against. We were uncertain what a traumatic brain injury was. We thought it would be like a concussion or something of that sort. We didn't realize it was something that would affect every part of her body.
Jessica basically had to learn to do everything again. She had to learn how to eat and swallow, talk, walk. Everything had to be relearned.
Hey, Dad.
Hi, beautiful.
Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Mom.
How are you feeling today? Better? Does your arm still hurt?
I didn't even realize how long it takes to recover from a traumatic brain injury. And they told me it's going to be a marathon. But she got better every day. It was something, one little thing.
Oh, won't you stay with me? 'Cause you're all I need.
We always had a phrase that we would say every day. She improved on something every day. Today, what would it be when we woke up? And sure enough, she would improve in some way. And little by little, we started seeing improvement. And that's the hope that we had. But we never thought about even spending time back here. All of our focus was being up there and focusing on Jessica, just improving in any way we can get her to do.
So Jessica, about, I would say a year ago, so it was about a year after her accident, she one day told us, she told the family that she remembers at the scene of the accident having some sort of out-of-body experience, I guess, and she saw herself there and she saw Jesus, and she said, Mom, I saw Jesus. And he went like this to me and he said, you will live. And we were like, oh my gosh, like she couldn't have made that up, you know? Is that right, Jess?
Yeah, that is right.
Can you tell us about that, Jess?
He was like, you will live again. And he gave me life again to the fullest.
Definitely still going to be a process. I think the hardest part is over, the critical part, you know, the just getting her to do what she's doing right now. All that's over and it's just going to improve. But we have a lot of hills to climb, you know, and she needs to work on her memory. She needs some job training. She needs to figure out what her future is going to look like. But we're all gonna be here for her. She's a different person. She's still Jessica. There's other things about her that are different or have changed. She's the sweetest thing ever. She's never been so sweet to me in her life. Very caring.
She'll just grab your face and just kiss you, and she won't let you go until she gets to kiss you all she wants, and she talks about how she loves Jesus, and she's just very, very happy. Everything is exciting. She wants to be a heart doctor. She wants to go to Denver and go to college because she has this connection now with Denver. She loves it. They just got back from Craig for a follow-up, and she said, I felt like I was home.
Really, it was really cool and really nice that my family was with me like through the whole process. I was at Craig Hospital, and like every step of the way, they were all there, all of them.
This is gonna be the best day of my life. My life.
Hi, so we're sitting here today with Tara Arellano, who is the president and founder of the Mariposa Network. And it's a nonprofit organization that was put together by Tara to help families who are dealing with brain trauma. Tara, tell us a little bit about that.
Sure. Our goal is to help the families and victims get the proper care to live a full and happy life.
I'm here to support the Mariposa Network and Bike for Brain Trauma event, which raises funds for family and victims recovering from traumatic brain injury.
This story touched me. I thought, what an opportunity to help someone in need, and really coming from my heart and wanting to make sure that, you know, someone like Jessica was taken care of. So
it's a touching story. It's all about overcoming adversity and working towards your goals, and that's something that we really want to be a part of.
If you have somebody that's been involved, you know, or has a brain injury or a traumatic brain experience, please get with Tara. Her organization is here to help people across the board, and it's the Mariposa Network. And thank you very much for joining us today.